This little gem is the 12-volt auto heater slash defroster. I picked this up at Harbor Freight, and sadly these get a lot of bad reviews, which is why I want to do a review on this and explain why these are actually very useful and what they can and can't do. Now, the first things first, let's talk about the limitations. First of all, this is not going to heat your car. It's not going to heat your pickup truck. It's not going to heat your tractor cab. And that's because there's a few constraints the manufacturer had to work around. The first thing is this accessory outlet. Most vehicles only have about 15, maybe 20 amps of service in the accessory ports. Now, I have a Volt, and it does have a 20 amp accessory port. Previous cars have only had 15, and I've also read online where some of them have even less. But I'm pretty sure today most cars are 15 or more, which means you can plug this in and use it. That constraint means there's only so much heat you can get out of this much electricity. You'll never be able to heat your entire car with one of these. That being said, it also does work really well. If you hold your hand out in front of it while it's on, you can feel a tremendous amount of heat and a tremendous amount of wind that is blowing against your hand. It does exceptionally well for what it is. Now let's talk about the design just a little bit. We'll be kind of quick here, but basically if you look at the front, you can see where the heat comes out here. You can see there's a flashlight here. We'll talk about that in a bit. And then there's another place that looks like it could be a flashlight, but it's a red indicator light that lets you know when the heater is on or off. There's a rubber membrane that covers the entire thing, which is great. If you're laying it on your dash, it's not going to scratch your dash or tear it up. It kind of keeps it from vibrating and sliding around. There's a switch on top. This is basically the flashlight on and flashlight off. There's another switch on the back, and that is so you can turn the heat on or you can turn the fan on. Now, when the heat's on, obviously the fan is on as well. And there's a center position, which is off. There's a little door on the side. It's actually a handle when you pull back on this. It's so you can use this as a spot heater. If you need to just use it somewhere on your car inside to heat up one area, you can definitely hang on to it. It's like a nice little handle. And overall, it's pretty light. It does feel like it's heavy enough that it's not made cheaply, yet it's not rock, so it's not super heavy. It's pretty nice, actually. One more feature that it does have is it does come with a mount that you can screw down to maybe a dash. I wouldn't put screws in my dash, but you never know. And it just kind of clips in here and then slides forward so you can make more of a permanent installation with this. Now this is a perfect example of when one of these devices makes sense. I'm currently in my car, it's a Chevy Volt, and the problem it's been having is the defrosters have stopped working. I've ordered the part to repair the defrosters, however it's on a 10-day back order, and I'm not going to see that part anytime soon. It's winter time, so the windows in my car fog up pretty easy while I'm commuting to and from work. I can keep myself warm, it has heated seats, I can put coats on, but what I could not do is keep this windshield clear, because as you can see from the passenger side, it pretty much fogs up pretty easy. But with one of these laying on the dash, just as you see now, I can keep my view perfectly clear. And this will be great until I can get the part to fix my defrosters. The built-in light is actually pretty bright. If you really needed a flashlight and you didn't have one, it has a long enough cord that you could probably work on something with this. Maybe an emergency, you need to fix something fast. As you can see, it's pretty bright. Not a bad feature. So there you have it, my quick and dirty review on this guy. And as I said, I think it works really well. It just gets a bad rap because a lot of people think this is going to heat their entire car. And it's just not designed for that. It pretty much excels at keeping your windshield clear, which is what it was designed for. I'll put a link down below where you can see a little more about this, see how much it costs. It's basically going to be a link to the Harbor Freight website. And I would like you to take a look at some of my other videos. I normally build some things and I fix some things. You just might be entertained.